Yes?
So, that's what you look like.
What are you talking about?
Just tell him V's outside.
When the hell did you get out?
Yesterday.
You didn't think you're coming back, are you?
Oh, I don't want to come back. I just brought you a present.
Breakfast bell. You're still not trying to prove you're innocent, are you? And you'll starve. All right, you heard the bell. Everybody out.
Frankie will kill you.
Come in.
Yes.
There's trouble in the dining room. Frankie started her move.
What happened?
They won't move.
Morning, Governor. Come to hear our complaints about the food, have you?
Have you any complaints?
No.
Then why aren't the girls at work?
Why ask me?
I was under the impression they do as you tell them.
Maybe.
Then please ask them to go back to work.
All right, you heard. Everybody out.
Shouldn't have given in to the bitch.
What do you suggest?
Throw her in solitary for a few days.
For what?
Insolence.
She has witnesses who will swear she was politeness itself. Just sit tight and let me know the minute anything else happens.
Meg, your son's here.
Well, where is he?
Outside in the garden. Wants to see you and Bill.
I don't know what I'm going to do with you, Chrissie. You worked in the kitchen, the garden, the library. Now the laundry workshop. Every time you come back and tell me it isn't exactly what you want. What exactly do you want?
You.
Now I'm being serious.
So am I.
It would appear that your visits here have been a waste of my time.
You bastard.
Oh, look, Chrissie, don't make a fool of yourself.
Well, it's all right for you, ain't it? You can go home to your wife every night. What am I supposed to do?
Look, Chrissie. Come in. Well, that'll be all for now anyway. Chrissie, you can stay working in the laundry. Send the next girl in, hmm? Well, what is it, Meg?
Well, Marty wants to talk to us.
Oh, when?
No, he's outside.
Well, can't you talk to him?
He wants to talk to both of us.
Yeah, well, he'll have to wait. I'm very busy.
Bill, if he's serious about leaving home, we've got to talk to him.
Look, I know, but not now. Could you wait outside just a minute, please, Jean? Meg? Meg? Come in.
Hi. What happened to the garden?
What does it look like?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around.
Is this your boy?
Darren, how many times have I told you not to speak to strange people? Marty?
Where's Dad?
He's busy.
He's always busy.
Well, the prisoners have lots of problems.
I've got problems too.
What problems?
That's what I want to talk to Dad about.
Can't you talk to me?
No.
Hey, Marty, your dad realizes he hasn't been spending a lot of time with you lately, but he really has been awfully busy. We both get off at 4. How about we jump in the car and go down to Frankston, have a swim, talk things over then?
It's Dad's night for lectures.
He said he'd cancel them.
Honest?
Honest.
Okay, then. I'll see you home at 4. Garden looks a mess.
Yeah. Mum would be upset if she could see it now.
You call her Mum? You know, the way you and Dad talk, anyone would think these prisoners were a family.
Hey, you. I'm talking to you. You gone deaf or something?
No.
Then how come you moved at breakfast when I told you not to?
She didn't mean anything.
Oh, shut up, you.
You don't have to take it out on Doreen. I don't need her to stick up for me. I just want to be left alone.
You'll be left alone when you're dead. In the meantime, you'll do like I tell you. Now, we're going through the same routine again at lunchtime, and if you so much as move a finger. What? You saw what happened to your friend Lynn. I won't just stick your hand in the press. I'll stick your pretty face in it.
You better do what she says. You can't win.
Karen Travers? You're wanted in Mr. Jackson's office.
Come in. Ah, Karen, shut the door. Well, take a seat. I understand you've started work in the laundry.
That's right.
Well, I think we can get you something better than that.
I don't want anything better.
I don't understand. Surely you'd prefer to be away from the, what shall we say, the rougher element? There is a job going in the library.
I don't want it.
Karen, I know how strange this must all seem to you, but you don't want to just give up. After all, you are a qualified schoolteacher.
I was a school teacher.
Well, that's what I mean. You don't want to throw away that education.
Who put you up to this?
This is what I'm paid for. To place prisoners where they're best suited.
It was Greg Miller, wasn't it?
Well, Dr. Miller and I have discussed your case,
yes.
I see. He tells me that you withheld certain evidence at your trial, material evidence.
We both think you stand a very good chance of a retrial.
I don't want a retrial.
But surely you don't want to spend the rest of your life in here.
I know, it's what I deserve. I killed my husband. I can't seem to get through to any of you, can I? You don't understand that all I want is to be left alone.
Got it. Here, where's that compact?
Shh.
Where's that compact you promised me? I went to a lot of trouble to get that.
Go on, enjoy Winchester.
What do you want with a load of old wire anyway?
It's my business. Where'd you get that?
Marilyn gave it to me.
It's empty, so it's no good anyway.
Whatever you two are up to, it better not interfere with my plans. We're having another sit-in at lunchtime.
What for?
You arguing with me?
No, I just don't know why we're doing it.
Because I said so.
What's going on here?
Nothing. Just a private chat.
Weren't you supposed to be seeing the psychologist this morning?
I've already seen him.
It was only a quickie today.
Well, you watch your mouth.
Oh, I only meant it was a quick visit.
Quiet! Just get on with your work.
Stupid cow. Doreen, that's the way rumors start.
Your turn will come, Doyle.
Well, Rosie, you're in excellent health. There's no reason why you shouldn't have a perfectly healthy baby. Oh, don't look so worried. We'll take care of you.
Is it true Mrs. Jackson was born in a prison?
Nick Jackson? Who told you that?
She did.
Well, then it must be true.
I don't want my baby born in a prison.
It won't be. We'll get you to the hospital in plenty of time. And meanwhile, try and stay as calm as possible and don't get excited.
A bit difficult with Frankie around.
Yes. Well, I'll see what I can do about getting you transferred to the mother's wing a bit earlier. Trouble is, it's already overcrowded. I'm sorry, Bill. I didn't know you were waiting.
No worries.
Come in. Now, remember, no excitement.
What can I do for you, Bill? More problems with Meg? No, although she's still not sleeping well. No, I thought I'd let you know I've had that chat with Karen Travers.
And?
It was a waste of time.
You told her she could have grounds for a retrial?
Well, of course, but she just doesn't seem to care. Now she's decided she deserves to be here.
Yeah. Yeah, well, thanks for trying, anyway.
It's all right. See you.
Bill? I had a talk to Marty.
Oh, what do you want?
Well, he wouldn't say. He wanted to talk to us both. I said we'd go down to Frankston after work, have a swim, talk things over.
Look, I can't. I've got lectures tonight.
They can manage without you for once. I promised Marty you'd be there.
You had no right to do that.
No right? We're talking about our son. If he's got problems, the least you can do is talk to him.
Look, I will. As soon as I've got time.
When's that going to be?
Okay, I'll be home at 4.
Thanks. You want me, Vera?
Yes, the paddy wagon will be here in 15 minutes.
I'll be there.
Trouble?
What? Oh, no. It's just Bill. He doesn't seem to have time for anything but work.
I suppose you've heard the rumors that he's playing around with one of the girls.
Grow up, Vera!
You know I've got a weak heart.
Oh, go on, you're as strong as an ox. Can you open it?
Of course I can open it. I can pick any lock in this joint.
Well, how come you're still here then?
Oh, I could get out if I wanted to, and I will one of these days, and I'll surprise everybody.
You'll surprise me the way you're struggling with that. Go down there and keep a watcher. Huh?
morning, Miss Bennett.
What's going on?
Machines have stopped.
Isn't that a surprise? What have you done about it?
Nothing. Only just happened.
I'll call an electrician.
We don't need an electrician to fix a fuse. I'll do it. Meanwhile, get this place cleaned up. It's filthy. You come with me, Doyle. I've got something to show you. Come on.
Oh, very pretty. Is that what you wanted to show me?
Don't be smart. Call an electrician. Come on, you.
What's all this about, then?
You'll find out.
Well, I'm not waiting around here all day.
You'll do as you're told. What do you think you run this place now?
Maybe.
Yes. You really think you're something, don't you? You didn't have the guts to take over when B. Smith was here.
I'm not afraid of B. Smith.
It's easy to say now she's gone.
I'd say it to her face, too.
Good. Here's your opportunity. Toad line.
Do we have to go through all this rubbish?
It's the law.
Look, I know the law as well as you do, Meg. My name is Beatrice Alice Smith. Yes, I killed my husband. He deserved it. Yes, I'm going to be here for the rest of my life. Now, why don't you just check through this lot and give me the form to sign and throw me into a cell?
Have you finished? Good. Now we'll do it our way. You had the chance to do it your way outside, and we all know what a mess you made of that. Please stand on the line. Come in.
B. Smith's back.
Yes, I know. Well, aren't you going to talk to her?
Not unless she specifically asks to speak to me. She'll be treated like any other new prisoner. Put her in solitary for observation.
But you can't do that.
Why not? It's the normal procedure.
But B. isn't a normal prisoner. Well, she practically ran this place before she was discharged. Well, you know what I mean. The other prisoners respect her. The sooner she's back in with them, the sooner we can put an end to Frankie's nonsense. We don't want a recurrence of what happened this morning.
Take care of it, would you?
Right. Right. Pick up your stools, please. Has B had her examination?
What are you so worried about? I was only out one day.
Who knows what you could have picked up in that time?
She's had her examination.
Good. The governor wants me to take special care of B. You're to take the other prisoner to her dormitory.
Very well.
This way.
How come I'm getting special attention?
Governor's instructions. She wants you back with your friends as soon as possible.
This is the one.
What's wrong with it?
Well, how should I know? It just keeps blowing.
I'd better take a look. Yeah, the wiring must be short-circuiting somewhere. I'll have to go up to the roof to find out.
How long will that take?
Don't know. It depends how hard it is to find. Could take all day.
Well, you'd better get on with it then.
Mm.
How long will it take?
About 2 minutes. I'll see you up in the room.
But I can't make it till
What's going on here?
Well, there seems to be the wiring's gone, and I'm going to have to rewire the whole circuit.
Yes, well, I'm sure you'll do it better without interference.
I was just going.
Come on. Right, in here.
What's all this junk?
They belong to a prisoner who's just been released. She was very attached to them.
Yeah? Well, if she cared about them so much, why didn't she take them with her?
Hopefully she's got something better now.
How much longer is it going to take to fix that fuse?
If it's Marilyn's boyfriend fixing it, it'll probably take all day.
Or all night.
Oh.
Oh, you're all right.
Here, sit down.
It's just a twinge.
Oh, you'll feel better when you've had something to eat.
No, I'm not hungry, thanks. Oh,
she ought to be over in the mother's wing.
Oh, no. Doc's trying to get me transferred, but apparently it's already overcrowded. I'll be okay when I get my breath back.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh, I don't see what you're so upset about.
That bitch Bee's back.
Bee Smith?
Yeah, she shot her old man. Well, she needn't think she's going to take over in here again. I'm in charge now, and I'll smash anyone who gets in my way. Understand? Now, we're going through the same routine again at lunchtime. And the first one to move gets it. Okay, let's go.
Sit anywhere. The others will be in soon.
You're really going out of your way to help, aren't you?
I told you. We always like to make old friends feel welcome.
Don't give me that bull. I know why I wasn't put into solitary. You can't wait for me and Frankie to get stuck into each other.
I don't know what you're talking about. Of course, if you'd rather let Frankie have a few more days to settle
in. All right, I get the picture.
Right, then. Move it along. Hurry up. Quiet, please, quiet.
You're sitting in my seat.
You've just been keeping it warm for me. Doreen, there's a spare seat here.
Oh, you're not due yet, are you?
Not for another month yet. I just want out of here. I know there's going to be trouble. I don't want my baby born into this. Get Mrs. Jackson, will you? Please.
Okay. Hold on.
Really?
Well,
she thought it was
coming,
but it didn't.
I'll
fix it anyway.
Okay. Oh. Mrs. Jackson,
Lynn,
change your mind about eating? No, it's Rosie. I think her time has come.
Rosie, is it the baby?
I don't know. I've just got this cramp in my stomach. I'm so scared.
There's nothing to be scared of. Now, how often are the pains coming?
I've only had one.
It's probably a false alarm.
Oh, don't leave me, Mrs. Jackson.
All right. right. You heard everybody out. I warned you. All those who are going, move out.
You must be disappointed. No violence.
Do now.
We'll talk in the laundry.
Well, Frankie, what are you going to do now? Sit there all day? I don't mind, but isn't it about time you made a move? What happened?
There was a riot in the dining room. They started throwing everything they could get their hands on.
You should have expected trouble. Couldn't you stop it?
I did my best. B and half the prisoners are locked in the work area, and Frankie and the rest are locked in the other wing.
Well, as long as they're apart, there shouldn't be too much trouble. Just keep the gates shut until they calm down.
Where's Meg?
I don't know.
Well, wasn't she on duty in the dining room?
Yes, but I didn't notice her in the confusion.
You mean she could still be in there?
We'd better take a look. You stay here.
friends to make sure you're locked up nice and safe.
It's not me they're protecting.
Oh, no. Wait until they open up these gates, then we'll see. That goes for you too, Doreen.
I didn't do anything.
Don't worry about her, Doreen. She's all mouth.
Yeah.
Where's Meg Jackson?
She's in here with us, and that's where she's staying until we get what we want.
And what's that?
For you screws to open up these gates, stand back and let me and B sort it out.
We can't do that.
Why not? There's going to be a showdown between us sooner or later. Why not now?
There'll be no showdown. Not while I'm in charge.
But you're not in charge, are you? Not behind these bars. And if any of yous forget it, just remember, we've got Meg Jackson.
She got out while the going was good.
She didn't do that.
How the hell would you know? You've only been inside 5 minutes. You'll soon learn all screws are the same.
Look, I'm sure you're wrong about her. She'll be back. Oh, look, Rosie, if she's not here in 5 minutes, I'll go and look for her, all right? Just hold on.
I haven't got much choice, have I?
There you are. How does it feel, eh? You being a prisoner for a change, eh? Well, I'm talking to you.
Leave her alone.
And you can shut up or they'll start on you. Looks like you're going to be here for a long time, doesn't it, eh? Oh, your family are going to miss you. Where's your big, strong husband now, eh? Why don't he come and help you? I bet you wish you were at home right now in bed with him, don't you?
So do you.
Stop it. Stop it, all of you.
What's the matter with you? Feeling hungry, are you?
No, it's Rosie. The time's come.
Who's sick?
She's right. She's got to get to the doctor.
Nobody tells me what I've got to do.
Do as she says, Frankie. This fight between you and B is one thing. But if anything happens to Rosie's baby, your life won't be worth living.
Have you found Meg?
Yes. She's with Frankie.
Oh, no. Well, what are we going to do now?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? We can't just leave her in there. We'll get some help from the men's prison.
No. If this leaks out, the newspapers will have a field day. We are not bringing in outside help.
Well, we've got to do something. This is my wife we're talking about.
She is also a prison officer. She knows the risks.
Risks? I've been trying to talk her into giving up this damn job for months. Well, you must have expected something like this to happen when B got back. Why wasn't she put in solitary?
It's too late to talk about what should have happened. Rosie's about to have her baby. Frankie has asked for the doctor to come to the security gates. They're bringing her out.
What do you think?
Well, she's still a month off, but with all the excitement, I'd better go and look.
I'll come with you.
Keep an eye on Bill. Make sure he doesn't do anything stupid.
Right.
Lock the gates. It could be a trick. Frankie? Where's Rosie?
Before we bring her out, I've got something to show you.
I'm all right.
And she'll stay that way just so long as you don't try anything. Bring her out. Open the gates.
Come after me, stupid girl!
Get back, you two. Inside.
Mum? Dad? Anybody home?
Anything happening?
Nothing. It's been quiet for some time. I reckon we should make a move.
What do you suggest?
Tear gas.
What about Mick?
We've got a good chance of getting her out okay. Besides, if they wanted to harm her, they'd have done it by now.
Rushing in and out might be just the excuse they're looking for.
What do you suggest? You said yourself we should do something.
Let me talk to Frankie. Try to persuade her to let Mick go.
You can't reason with Doyle. She's an animal.
Well, maybe she wouldn't be if you didn't treat her like
that. All right, all right. What have we got to lose?
Hear that? Your old man wants to talk to me.
I wonder what he wants.
Perhaps he fancied you.
He's not my type. All right. You want to talk? Be at the gate in 5 minutes. Just you and the screw with the keys. Nobody else. And remember, no tricks.
You're wasting your time.
Bill Jackson's going to talk to Frankie.
Oh, let him talk. That'll do no good. There's only two people who can settle this. Me and Frankie.
What are we going to do now?
Oh, will you shut up? I'm trying to think.
Okay. This is what we're going to do. I'm going to let Bill Jackson persuade me to release his wife. Chrissie, you shove her in when they open up the gates, okay? Then, Lizzie, you grab the keys. You've got the screw, remember? Don't let her go. Then, when you open up the other gates, everybody rush inside. That's everybody for themselves, okay? Now, leave.
Just hold the time and place until you get a chance to run for it. Thanks.
Just remember, no matter what happens, I'm not involved.
Now, if any of you's let me down.
Can I speak to Bill Jackson? What about Mrs. Jackson? So they're there.
Time to go in.
Wait until the tear gas is broken out.
Well, I'm hoping we won't need it.
Wait, just the same. Ready?
Almost.
What's the holdup?
Well, I had to talk to the electrical contractors. They want to know where their electrician is.
Well, what has that to do with us?
Well, he came here hours ago to fix a fuse.
You sure that was a riot alarm?
Who cares?
Well, I could get the sack, you know.
Can't help it if you were locked up, can you?
I better go down there and take a look, you know. I gotta go.
Eddie, I'll see you again.
Yeah, sure you will. Thanks.
Remember, just you and the screw with the keys. What do you want?
I want you to let Mrs. Jackson out.
Why should I?
Frankie. You're not doing any good by holding her. You're only putting yourself in a worse mess.
What could be worse than this?
You could spend the rest of your life in here. Look, B should never have been allowed in with the rest of you straight away. She should have been kept in solitary. Now, if you let Meg out, I'll testify before any inquiry that this trouble was caused by the authorities breaking their own rules. Look, you've nothing to lose by letting her out.
Okay. Bring her out. Frankie is up to something. Tell everybody to get ready.
Last night I dreamed we were together.